Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 3.2, Problem 1. This is Section 3.2, Problem Number 1. It says, consider the sample 20, 13, 4, 8, and 10. Find the range, find the variance, and find the standard deviation. So the range is simply the largest value minus the smallest value. So as we look, the largest value is 20 minus the smallest value is 4, and 20 minus 4 is 16. So the range is 16. That's easy enough. Now for the variance, finding the variance is a four-step process. Step one is find the mean and label it x bar. So the mean, or what most people would call the average, we're going to add these numbers together, divide by 5 because there are 5 numbers. So 20 plus 13 plus 4 plus 8 plus 10 divided by 5 because there are 5 data values. 20 and 13 is 33, 33 and 4 is 37, 37 and 8 is 45, 45 plus 10 is 55. We divide by 5 because, again, there are 5 data values. 55 divided by 5 is 11. And we label that x bar. That's the symbol for the mean of a sample. That was step 1. Step 2, fill out the chart. Our chart will have 3 columns. One for x, one for x minus x bar, and one for x minus x bar in parentheses raised to the second power. So for the x column, just put in your data values. We have 20, 13, 4, 8, and 10. And then from each one of those data values, subtract off the x bar, which is 11 from step 1. So in the top row, x minus x bar will be 20 minus 11, which is positive 9. In the next row, x is 13, so x minus x bar is 13 minus 11, which is positive 2. In the middle row, x is 4, so x minus x bar is 4 minus 11, which is negative 7. And the next row down, x is 8, so x minus x bar 8 minus 11 is negative 3. And finally in the bottom row, x is 10, so x minus x bar is 10 minus 11, which is negative 1. And at this point of the process, when you finish the work for your middle column, it's not a bad idea to check to see if it adds up to a total of 0. If it does, that's a good sign. If it doesn't, you've made a mistake. 2 and 9 is positive 11. Negative 7, negative 3, negative 1 is negative 11. If you total that up, it does give you 0. So that's good. Now the last column, take the answers for x minus x bar and raise them all to the second power. So in the top row, x minus x bar was 9. So I'll do 9 second power, which is 9 times 9, which gives me an 81. The next row, my answer for x minus x bar was 2, so I'll have 2 to the second power, 2 times 2, which is 4. In the middle row, the x minus x bar was negative 7, so I'll have negative 7 second power. Negative 7 times negative 7 is positive 49. Again, the negative times negative, remember the negatives cancel. The next row down, my answer for x minus x bar was negative 3, so I'll do negative 3 second power. Negative 3 times negative 3 is positive 9. And finally in the bottom row, the answer for x minus x bar was negative 1, so I'll raise that to the second power. Negative 1 times negative 1, positive 1. So here's the result for step 2. Step 2 is fill in the chart. There's the chart that's filled in. Step 3, get a total of the last column. So as I total this up, you can add going right down, you can add it with a calculator. I can see that 81 and 49 combine nicely to make 130. 9 and 1 is 10, 130 and 10 more is 140, and then plus 4, you'd get 144. Or you could just add right in a row. But however you do it, the total of the last column is 144. That's step 3. I have a total of the last column. 81 plus 4 plus 49 plus 9 plus 1 gives me a total of 144. Step 4, the final step for variance, is take the result from step 3, divide by n minus 1 for a sample, and this is a sample, it says so in the question, and n is how many data values. So I will have 144 over n minus 1. N is 5 because I have 5 data values. So 144 over n minus 1 becomes 144 over 5 minus 1, which is 144 over 4. Now I can see that that reduces pretty nicely to 36. If you don't see that, you're not comfortable with it, you think it's 36, but you're not 100% positive, just take 2 seconds with your calculator and enter 144 divide by 4, and you should get 36, and you will. And that's the variance. The variance is 36. That's the result of our four-step process that we have here. And part C, find the standard deviation. The standard deviation is the square root of what the variance is, so it'll be square root of 36, and that comes out to a nice whole number of 6. That's a little bit unusual. Usually the standard deviation is going to give you a decimal. So the square root of 36 is 6 because 6 times 6 is 36. And if you want to use the symbol, again, the symbol for standard deviation would be lowercase s.